Hi everyone, this is the second episode of my series on 19 tone equal temperament. This time I'm going to talk about the system's intervals and what they can do. But before I look at each one, I need to go over a bit of nomenclature. If we want to talk about the accuracy of intervals, we need a way to name very small differences in pitch. The unit we use for this is called the cent. 1 cent is 1/100th of a half step, or 1/1200th of an octave. Individual cents are too small to hear, but they allow us to describe tiny distances precisely. The example from the last video, 27 to 16 versus 5 to 3, was a difference of about 22 cents. With that out of the way, let's see what the intervals of 19 TET look like. The smallest one is the chromatic semitone, small semitone, or third tone. Since it's smaller than anything we encounter regularly, it sounds pretty strained and unfamiliar. It's 8 cents smaller than 25 to 24. The next interval is the large or diatonic semitone. It's called diatonic because it's the one that appears in the diatonic scale. Because it's slightly larger than the 12 TET semitone, cadences using it may be a little less satisfying. That's a place where you can bring in some small semitones if you want a little more smoothness. Next is the whole tone. Notice that the whole tone is 3 steps and the diatonic semitone is 2. The fact that those two intervals are closer in size than they are in 12 TET subtly contributes to 19 TET's sound. 4 steps make an interval which doesn't have much of an analog in 12 TET. No 12 TET interval approximates a ratio with a factor of 7, except arguably the tritone. This interval is called the supermajor second or subminor third. I like to call it the half fourth because it's half a fourth. Next is the minor third. In terms of closeness to just intonation, 19 TET's minor third is essentially perfect. To compare, 12 TET's minor third is 16 cents flat. 19 TET's version may not sound more in tune to you because it's unfamiliar, but it's more pure. 1 step larger is the major third. 19 TET's major third is more accurate than 12 TET's, but because it's off in the opposite direction, it sounds stranger. The new sizes of the thirds make them no longer symmetrical. 4 minor thirds overshoot the octave, and 3 major thirds undershoot it. Between the third and fourth is the supermajor third. This is another interval with no analog in 12 TET. Next is the perfect fourth. 19 TET's fourths and fifths are 7 cents off just intonation. In comparison, 12 TET's fifths are only 2 cents off. In terms of accuracy, there's a trade-off between thirds and fifths. One more step gives us the small tritone or augmented fourth. It's quite flat compared to both the 12 TET tritone and most ratios which are considered tritones. This small tritone is not even that far above 11 to 8, which is halfway between 12 TET's perfect fourth and its tritone. Next is the large tritone or diminished fifth. This is the tritone between the 7th and 4th degree of the major scale. The fact that 19 TET has 2 tritones has interesting consequences. 1 step larger is the perfect fifth. This, of course, has the same accuracy as the perfect fourth. The fact that the perfect fifth is slightly flatter than 12 TET's has effects on tonality in the circle of fifths, which I'll talk about in a future video. Adding 1 step makes the augmented fifth. This is the same as 2 major thirds. It's not the same as a minor sixth, because enharmonics work differently in 19 TET. The minor sixth is an inverted major third, so it has the same accuracy as 1. The major sixth, being an inverted minor third, is close to perfect. 1 step higher is the subminor or harmonic seventh. This is another interval with a factor of 7, and so it doesn't really appear in 12 TET. It inverts to the supermajor second or half fourth. The harmonic seventh has some very interesting uses, which I'll talk about another time. That's 1 step below the regular minor seventh. That's what you'll find in a diatonic minor or dominant 7th chord. Next is the major 7th. It's not as high as the 12 TET major 7th because 19 TET's diatonic semitones are wider. 19 TET also has the supermajor 7th. It's a 5th above the supermajor 3rd. It sounds somewhat strained. Finally, there's of course the octave. Because notes an octave apart are considered equivalent, the octave is what we divide up to get our notes. Equal temperament or not, the vast majority of tuning systems are built from a just octave. Well, those are the intervals of 19 TET. Listing all of them may have been a bit tedious, but I hope you found something to think about. Next time, I'll begin to discuss putting these intervals together to make chords.